Susan Benghazi Rice gets destroyed after claiming POTUS Trump's America First agenda is making us less safe. The stench from the Obama administration is still lingering. Lie and Susan Rice attacked President Trump's America First agenda this week, and Trump supporters responded accordingly. Susan Rice attacked President Trump's America First agenda in a New York Times op-ed titled "When America No Longer Is a Global Force for Good." In the opening paragraph, Rice claims Trump's national security strategy marks a dramatic departure from his predecessors. President Trump's national security strategy marks a dramatic departure from the plans of his Republican and Democratic predecessors, painting a dark, almost dystopian portrait of an extraordinarily dangerous world characterized by hostile states and lurking threats. There is scant mention of America's unrivaled political, military, technological and economic strength, or the opportunities to expand prosperity, freedom and security through principled leadership, the foundation of American foreign policy since World War II. Thanks to Trump letting our military actually do work, ISIS has been reduced to a fraction of what it was under Obama. Obama funded ISIS and tied our military's hands, which made ISIS metastasize. Take many seats, Susan Rice. The former NATSEC advisor then attacked Trump's nationalistic ideals and claimed Trump believes we live in a world where America wins only at others' expense. There is no common good, no international community, no universal values, only American values. Nothing could be further from the truth. Trump refuses to apologize for America's accomplishments and refuses to bow to foreign leaders, unlike weakling Obama. That makes us a leader, which strengthens the world. When we are weak, evil proliferates. Susan Rice then brought up Russia, shocker. Russia, as the strategy allows, aggressively opposes NATO, the European Union, Western values and American global leadership. It brazenly seized Georgian and Ukrainian territory and killed thousands of innocents to save a dictator in Syria. Russia is our adversary, yet Mr. Trump's strategy stubbornly refuses to acknowledge its most hostile act, directly interfering in the 2016 presidential election to advantage Mr. Trump himself. Russia did not interfere in our presidential election to Trump's advantage. This is a blatant lie. Rice then attacks Russia as being a nation which opposes Western values and NATO, but fails to mention Turkey. Turkey should be thrown out of NATO as they have become increasingly hostile with a pro-Islam/ISIS leader like Erdogan. Turkey previously shot down Russian jets in what many say was an aggressive attempt to flex military muscle. If Russia retaliates, the United States could be dragged into a war if Article V of NATO is invoked. Susan Rice then had the nerve to attack Trump for wanting to build a border wall, limit refugees, and lashed out at him for squashing TPP, Trans-Pacific Partnership. But the nationalists around him succeeded in enshrining Mr. Trump's harsh anti-immigration policies, from the border wall to ending family preferences and limiting refugee admissions. They reprised their plea to bilateral over multi-nation trade agreements and trumpeted the abrogation of the Trans-Pacific Partnership, which would help check China's economic and strategic expansionism in Asia. The result is an insular, ideological treatment of our complex world, substantially unimpaired by facts and dismissive of United States interests. We are not constitutionally obligated to extend American citizenship to anyone. American citizenship is a privilege, not a right. We have borders for a reason. TPP would have been disastrous for Americans, which is why Trump rightfully struck it down. One of the dangerous elements of TPP was outlined in a Breitbart article explaining how Sharia law can creep into the United States, being that Brunei, a country which recently adopted Sharia law, can essentially drag us into an international court and sue us if we don't agree to their terms, even if it puts our national security at risk. Islamic refugees are ravaging and raping every nation they step foot in. Not only are they dangerous, most are uneducated or carry exotic diseases the U.S. has either never seen before or already snuffed out. To argue that refugees somehow enrich our nation is absurd. Susan Rice finished off her piece by complaining about oppressed LGBT people and brought up Trump's anti-Semitism ... The Obama administration will go down as the most anti-American in history. It was full of the most corrupt group of criminals to ever hold public office. Benghazi, Hezbollah drug trafficking, Uranium One, Iran nuclear deal, Obamacare, unmasking, Russia dossier. The list goes on and on. And on.